Hello everyone and welcome to Usitility. Today we are going to see how to play Blade of Chaos Immortal Titan on PC using the brand new BlueStacks 5 that is designed for blazing fast speed and high octane action. We will be able to easily download and install Blade of Chaos Immortal Titan and enjoy the game on our Windows PC with keyboard, mouse and big screen thanks to BlueStacks 5, which is the Android emulator that we recommend to play Blade of Chaos Immortal Titan. So without further ado, let's get to it. First of all folks, the first thing to do is to launch our favorite browser. We selected the one we use by default. Let's go to this URL that I have highlighted in green color. Now, you are able to discover on the screen of the PC. There is no need to type the URL, simply because there's the clickable link in the description of this video and as well in the first main comment. We ended up on this page on our own website of Usitility, where we have an in-depth outline on the best way to obtain Blade of Chaos Immortal Titan on laptop or computer. We search down a bit and click on the Download Game on PC button. Once we click on the link, we reach the site of BlueStacks. No panic, it is only the Android emulator that we are going to run to enjoy the game Blade of Chaos Immortal Titan on our PC. As you can see from here, we get several pros of preferring using this emulator. So we are on the way to proceed to download the Blade of Chaos Immortal Titan by clicking on the button Play on BlueStacks that you can see here in green color. The step is clicking on it. And the download action starts and ends immediately. Voila, here is located the download. It is a file we have to execute. The following step is to launch the executable file, okay, then we click on this file. If we are on Windows 10 it will have asked us for permission to make changes to the laptop or device. We answered yes. I minimize the web browser to view the installer much better. The installer is very easy to use. It consists of a couple of choices, install, and setup path. I will show you what setup path does indeed. We simply just click it. And so we discover that we display here the path where the emulator will be installed. If we would you like to change for better this folder we have got to click on this browse option, so we select another folder and set up the emulator precisely where we choose. To keep it simple, just keep it as it is. Then, I click on back. So I click on install. Voila! The installation starts and it is going to carry on along with the download of those MB which are shown on that computer screen. As you save it on your machine, it might possibly be slightly more or less MB. The data transfer rate may go at a higher speed or at a lower speed, determined by your connection and depending on the velocity of the emulator hosting servers. Right away they're running quite fast. The download is finished, and now it proceeds with the installation phase. With BlueStacks 5 you can even reduce RAM usage with a single click. Especially useful if you ever face performance-related problems. In addition, you can activate Eco mode to enjoy 87% reduced CPU usage, 97% reduced GPU usage and easier multitasking. As you can see, BlueStacks 5 is built to provide stability and performance during long gaming sessions. The installation has already finished for me. At present, the emulator has actually been launched automatically. As you can discover, down here, there is a progress bar that will move forward to the right when it attains the finish, the emulator is started for the first time. The truth is the emulator has already been launched there for the first time. Before we carry on, as you can see, it has created a couple of software icons right here on the computer desktop. The BlueStacks and BlueStacks Multi Instance. Note that the BlueStacks software icon will be one we are concerned with. At any time when we need to start Blade of Chaos Immortal Titan on the desktop or laptop, we twice click on that software icon and therefore use the emulator. The BlueStacks multi-instance icon allows you to launch multiple emulator instances. And with BlueStacks 5's new improved multi-instance manager in Eco mode, players can run more game instances faster and with less lag. Shall we perform the next step, which is a must-have, and this is to begin browsing the Google Play Store. And we will click on Play Store. As you can observe the Google Play is launched. Here we have got to log on. At this point when we are on this page, we have to perform this following step that is obligatory. Therefore mouse click on Sign In. Presently it announces Checking Info. It may sometimes get stuck in Checking Info, additionally it isn't going to advance. If that's the case, you can try to connect to your account after a couple of hours and it may quite likely be solved. At this time we will enter our email and password. The email ought to be a Gmail email address as well as its associated password. For example, you can utilize the same exact email you use at this moment in your own YouTube account. So that I will enter my details and I'll go back after I have done it. Voila, details entered. Here is Google welcoming us and presenting us their tools. We can consent to all of them simply by clicking I agree. Following that, it allows us to back up to the Google Cloud. You can leave it selected. It's going to make a backup of your files on this device to Google Drive. I won't check it, you can use that option if you like. We mouse click on accept. Google Play Store is launched by default and on autopilot. To set up the video game, we must get to the Android emulator desktop by clicking that app icon indicated green colored. At present that we are watching the desktop of the emulator, we can see that we come with right here the install application option. We simply click on the button. Listed here we access to the video game. So let's click now on the install link that I'm just showing now in green color. That click will initiate the setup. Now it will install the game app, it can take a little while or perhaps it could also be extremely fast. It again all is dependent upon on our own connection to the web. This has by then completed setting up. It's time to go back to the emulator desktop by simply clicking that button that I am emphasizing in green, so that you can use Blade of Chaos Immortal Titan for the first time. We're already on the emulator desktop, and as a consequence we're preparing to mouse click on that brand new Blade of Chaos Immortal Titan app icon that's been generated. This game is launched for the first time. So there we get it, I can also press anywhere on the screen and also make use of the keyboard. I should comment on the volume of that emulator. It's right here. We have got the icon of higher volume as well as the icon of lower volume. This manner we do not rely on the Microsoft Windows volume to increase or decrease the sound experience of your emulator. And also to appreciate the experience to the max, we can turn on the large monitor, for which we have two choices. This one is simply the very first one, we mouse click on this icon which I am indeed showing in green color. Thus the display screen is maximized, enjoying one border at the top, one on the right side and the last one at the bottom. In the event that we want to enjoy the application using all the screen, we hit this particular application icon. And we'd already be experiencing and enjoying the Android game in 100% screen setting. To get out of the 100% screen setting, push the F11 key. And we might already play in regular display setting. At present, I am ready to explain you the computer keyboard mapping which is rather exciting. That strategy we will likely be ready to utilize the game application far more effortlessly. The first task is to press this application icon. It's now time to make the recommended configuration settings. I most certainly will put the standard settings, but if you need to improve this, you may well do this with no problem. Obviously, the emulator is absolutely in our language. Sometimes it happens that your emulator is started in the erroneous language, for instance, in Mandarin. And as a consequence to set it up in the correct language we go here to the cogwheel. Then here within many other options, we mouse click on the language drop down. We should determine the language we wish, Spanish, Japanese, and so on. As soon as the language is determined, we are going to save, the emulator will restart, as well as the game app, next time we start it, would also be in the specified language. At this point, there is another detail that we have to take into consideration, and it's that we will get a message from Google Mail reporting that a brand new electronic device has been connected with this Google account. It will certainly check with us if we're the people who have associated with that device. Absolutely, we must not get worried, as the emulator is simulating an Android device. So you can discover which device is being emulated, we visit right here, to the cogwheel and we click on it. Be sure you go here to the model option. And here we realize that the emulator is simulating a Samsung cellular phone. And so we're going to receive an email saying that a new Samsung device has been connected to our Google account. That's all folks, so much for the video user demo. I anticipate you enjoyed it, specifically that everyone thought it was helpful. In this case, bring it a superb thumb up, subscribe to our channel, and any comments, requests or ideas, let them in the comment field below. You may also leave comments on my Twitch channel, I do live streams every now and then, you have it below in the video description and in the first pinned comment. Just click on any of the online videos which are usually appearing on the listing of videos to watch and let's have fun again in the future online videos. Bye!